Have you been disappointed by the performance of your Tag air conditioner? Well, stick around and I'll show you our possible solution. So when a lot of people see one of these small trailers, the first thing they think is that I bet that air conditioner will freeze you out of there. And one would think so with the small spaces this is. However, I think there's a flaw in the design that kind of prevents that. I'm hoping that the fix that I've come up with will solve that at least to a point. What I've found in looking at the design of this air conditioner is that it's basically a window air unit put into an internal space. So the part that would normally be sitting outside on a window unit is actually completely enclosed behind here. So what that does is that part generates heat, and so that heat is also stuck inside the trailer. The way they have mitigated that is there is an intake fan over in here, another one back over on that side that pulls air inside from an external intake. And then there's one other fan down here below that blows the hot air out down below. There is also vents on both sides of the air conditioner that is also there to alleviate some of that heat buildup. So what I've noticed with this system is that as the day gets warmer outside and humidity gets higher, it seems like the air conditioner is fighting itself. It's got hot air building up and some of it's coming out the side vents, and the air conditioner just can't quite keep up against the heat that it's producing. So my thought, and I preface this by saying that I am by no means an expert and know very little about air conditioning systems, but my thought is there are two fans coming in blowing air into behind this air conditioner, and yet there's only one down below pulling the air, the hot air out to exhaust it down below the trailer. So what I think may work is by adding a second fan down below, and I purchased these little fans here just off Amazon. But I believe that if we put two down below, so there are two pulling air in and two exhausting air out, it will help pull all this hot air that's building up behind the air conditioner completely out of the trailer. So first off, let's pull this panel off below and kind of see what we're looking at and what we're working with that fan down there. So as you can see, this fan is attached to this little wooden block here, which holds it into this space. And there's plenty of room back there to put two fans. And I've purchased this little kit that will attach the two fans together so we can just attach it as a unit to this wood block. So as I sat here and looked at this for a second, I'm thinking the best bet would probably be, first off, figure out where the wiring for this fan goes to and how we're going to wire in the new fans. So in looking at this, it appears that the wiring probably comes up and goes back behind this cabinet, which is where the intake fan is on this side. Well, I was really hoping not to do this, but it looks like the air conditioner may have to come out. All right, looks like there's two screws at the bottom, and hopefully that's about it. Of course, the only thing on the trailer that's Phillips. I know there's a drain hose back there somewhere, so that might be what's holding it up. That and the power cord comes from down here and then loops in behind here, so we may have to unplug it first too. So the drain doesn't appear to be an issue because it's on a pan that's separate from the air conditioner. I think it just is this power cable here. So I think if I unplug it from back there, it should be good. All right, looks like I'm gonna have to unplug that outlet as well. And so I have the trailer plugged in this time, so I'm gonna go ahead and unplug that and make sure there's no safety issues. So I immediately noticed a couple issues. One, this foil tape here was taped to this foam channel back behind there. Now, of course, once I pulled this out, it is no longer taped there. So I'm gonna have to figure out a way to tape that back. Other than that, I think I can actually get to the wiring now and fix what I need to fix back there. All right, well, I took a break, I came back. I'm kind of looking over the system and seeing where there's possibly other improvements that could be made. I think the fan idea is still gonna help, but I think there's a couple other things that'll help a little bit more, or at least will also help. One thing I did notice that I'll get to first. In several of the tag forums I had read that they had mentioned this drain pan that's below the air conditioner. And the problem is this plug back here is, if you look, it sticks up about a tenth of an inch above the bottom of the pan. So before it ever starts draining down that tube, you have a tenth of an inch of water sitting in this pan. And so anybody with humidity issues, that could be part of it if that gets sucked up into the air conditioner. So looking at the air conditioner itself, you can see that the air comes in and is pulled into these vents all around the outside here. And this fan pushes the air through the coils, and then the exhaust fans in the camper push it down to the outside. Here's the problem that I see. Where the intake fans come in, they come in on both sides on the outside of where this styrofoam trough or whatever you want to call it is. Supposedly, that tape around the outside of the air conditioner is run along the outside of the styrofoam. Well, you can see, especially at the top here, since this will not even stay down, that it was not taped down like it should have been. So therefore, the air that was getting pushed out the back of the air conditioner was then coming up and mixing in with all the intake air. Now, I think that's part of the problem, as that air was coming through here and then blowing wherever and through the exhaust ports here and out into the camper. I think if I can find a way to get this tape to where it holds this in place again and keeps that exhaust air going down as well instead of out everywhere, I think that will greatly help this whole process as well. The problem I'm seeing is trying to get back there once this air conditioner is back in here to be able to push that tape down against that styrofoam. I think maybe if I could take this back panel off here, I think I may be able to reach down in there and get my arm around where that air conditioner goes. All right. Well, that is out. So I can at least push down the top. Let's see if I can get it up there far enough to get my arm down around the side.
Not quite. I can get about halfway down. That's it.
So out of curiosity, I decided to see if I pulled the converter out, if I could get my arm in there and reach that side at least. And that actually works. So the next thought is, if I can get this radio off, I don't know if that's gonna be enough space that I can get my arm in, maybe, and reach this side. We'll have to check it and see. Sure enough, I can reach it. All right, so I ran out of time yesterday, so this is the next day. I think first thing I'm gonna work on today is go ahead and cut the wires on this old fan, pull that off, and then work on assembling the other two fans and then attaching those to this plate. So the wires that come down that went to that fan are just these small wires from the fan itself, and then they're spliced into heavier wires. What I think I'm going to do is probably splice in a little bit heavier wire as a lead and then connect the positive and negative terminals together on this and splice it into that. I'll grab some electrical tape, put around these just so that wire there is not exposed. All right, now we'll feed that back down through and pull it out the hole down there. So everything's wired up, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn the power on real quick and test it out and see if they're working. So far so good, and they're blowing in the right direction, so I think we're good. I think it's just time to put everything back. Now for the piece of this project that actually may be more beneficial than the fan was, and that is trying to get this air conditioner reinstalled and taped back to this foam box better than what they had from the factory. So as you can see from the factory, the air conditioner slides inside this styrofoam, and then they had this tape folded over so that it would stick to the inside of that foam. which has proven to be completely ineffective and has allowed the air to bypass that and go around as the foam box kind of expanded. So I'm going to try a two-fold approach. I'm going to put some more foil tape on the air conditioner itself, fold it over the way they had from the factory, as well as put some that's double thick around the outside of the foam box so that it can also stick from there, hopefully holding that foam box in place better than what it was originally. All right, so I got the outside of the air conditioner all cleaned up, got the old tape off, so it's all ready now to put the new tape on and then get it put back in place. So trying to keep all the wires out of the way is a challenge. All right, pretty much got the tape done now. All right, well, so I filled up the memory card right before I was putting in the air conditioner. So, being that I'm not going to pull it back out and do it again, just trust me, it went in okay. The biggest issue was this side where this cord was and trying to keep the cord from messing up the tape on this side. But I've looked around, I got the flashlight and I looked around the edge and everything seems to be pretty decent. It doesn't, like I said, this side over here stuck a little bit to the air conditioner, but it still looks to be fine. The rest of it all still looks to be away from the air conditioner. Now, I just need to tighten up the screws at the bottom to make sure the air conditioner is in the right spot, and then reach around from each side and push that tape down against the air conditioner. So it looks to be in decent shape. All right, well, that's all in, and now it's just a matter of putting everything else back together. All right, so everything's back together. I ran it for a little bit. It seems to be working fine. So hopefully all is good. Unfortunately, until it gets to the middle of summer, I'm really not gonna know how well this has worked or if it didn't work. So stay tuned, and I'll make sure I post videos later this summer letting everybody know how this is working. Also, if anybody has any comments, please post those down below. I would love to hear it. Like I said, I'm not an expert on this by any means. This is just kind of something I came up with off the top of my head. So, I mean, if somebody has a better idea, please let me know. If somebody sees something I did that was completely wrong that I shouldn't have done, let me know. I'm really interested on what everybody else's thoughts are on this modification. So if you're interested in trying this, I will leave affiliate links down below for all the parts that I end up buying. I got everything off Amazon, so it's easy to purchase all that stuff. I think this one actually is probably turned into a long one. So anyhow, thank you all for watching if you made it this far, and I will see you all in the next one.